Hi there. Let's take some minutes to learn how to use object settings in this video. In general, this is a new tab in ActivePresenter 8. It's come in handy to help you create default objects to optimize your work time. After customizing objects in the setting view, newly inserted objects will inherit all the properties that you have adjusted, in case they are the same object type. Take a look at my project. It contains many questions slide about music, which was created by ActivePresenter. Now, I'm going to set answering time for each question. However, this may take much time, if I have to repeat all setting steps for each animated timer object. Hence, using default animated timer is my solution. There are two types of animated timer: timer, and progress. For the short questions, I will use progress, which counts down from 10 seconds. Meanwhile, for the longer questions, I prefer timer, which counts down from 15 seconds. The essay question and rating scale question are exceptions. Next, let's open the object settings view in the view tab to customize default animated timer for my quiz. As you can see, the settings view includes three main parts: the commands for editing default objects. The left pane consists of 12 object groups. Each object group has its own default object. And the canvas previews changes when you customize default objects. As mentioned above, I need to customize animated timers objects. So, click timers. The default timer will appear on the canvas, with default time and appearances like this. Navigate to the timer properties pane. You are free to change its style and effects, size and properties, and interactivity. Remember to change the timer duration by going to the timer section in the interactivity tab. These three options are turned on by default. However, the object duration is hidden because the match object duration box is checked. It means the timer duration is the same as the default slide duration. To modify object duration as you wish, uncheck this box. In addition, I want to add events, actions for timer. When timer is complete, timeout feedback will be shown, and learners won't have the chance to answer the question. After customizing, if you aren't satisfied with the change, it is possible to reset. ActivePresenter offers you two options. To reset an individual object, right-click the object, and click Reset Default Settings. To reset all objects to default, click Reset All Object Settings, and select Yes. Then, do the same steps with the progress, to have a default progress object you want. Finally, click Close Settings View. Let's insert animated timer objects to the corresponding questions. All changes you've made are applied to all newly inserted progress and timer. Now, preview the quiz to see the result. That's all the techniques for setting default objects by using object settings in ActivePresenter 8. Hope that it helps. Thanks for watching.